What's up, folks? Today we're going to be taking a look at ZoomInfo. If you don't know who ZoomInfo are, then you must have been living under a rock for the past 10 years because they're one of the largest contact data sales intelligence solutions out there. I sat down to start trying to record this video a couple of weeks ago, and then it started asking me to add target accounts, add things to my website, and I was like, dang, I obviously need to do some setup here before I do a full review, so I went and did that. But in doing that, I realized there's a ton more to it than just grabbing contact information and mobile phone numbers. But let's take a look at the advanced search, which is where I think a lot of people will spend most of their time in the platform. So in the advanced search, you've got all the classic fields that you'd expect. If you use LinkedIn Sales Navigator or even just core LinkedIn, company size, company geography, contact geography, job title, revenue, industry, all those types of things you'd come to expect. And you can search for companies, contact, or scoops. And my understanding of scoops is it's like a trigger, a reason or change or something going on in the account that might give you a good reason to reach out to that account. So I can select my sales training buying committee, and immediately we get 270,000 contacts. And in that buying committee that I set up, it's like sales enablement, VP of sales, CRO. And then I can do my company account. So let's just do a minimum employee count 50 and max account 1,000. So this is where we start to use the sales signals. And as I mentioned before, these are like triggers. So I can select when the scoop happened, if it's recent or is it something that happened within 6 months. And then I can select a scoop type. So there's financial scoops, divestitures, earnings, mergers, funding, IPOs, those types of things. There's general business scoops. They've won an award, they've attended an event, they've relocated their office, they've entered a new geography, they've launched a new product. There's opportunity scoops, and this one's probably the most interesting to me because you can literally type in a pain point or project or initiative, and if ZoomInfo can pick it up, it will find people who have an active project or initiative or pain point related to what you sell. And then finally, there's the personal scoops, which is executive moves, hiring plans, layoffs, people leaving company, open positions, people who have been promoted. So let's do pain point. And then I'm going to type in a keyword of sales training. Whoopity-doo. And now we're seeing a list of scoops and companies who are showing signals that they're facing pain points or projects related to sales training. So Cody Labs says a frontline source in social and relationships has indicated the organization is planning to begin initiatives related to sales automation and enablement. That means for me as a sales trainer and someone who offers keynotes and those types of things, they're a worthwhile company to reach out to and connect with. So it's pretty incredible you can go a layer deeper than even what LinkedIn is able to provide to you. The next one here is intent. This is the thing that really took some time to set up a couple of weeks back. You can set up intent topic clusters. Set up key areas where people at those companies might be searching for that relate to your product, service, the pain points you help with, and then you can target people based on what accounts and what people at those accounts are showing some level of intent for what you sell. So if I go to intent score high and I select my keynote ops, I'll go to short term, so people who have been searching for this topic in the past couple of weeks. Clio, which is a legal software based in Canada, has been searching for sales trainers and keynote speakers recently. Someone at their account at least. Therefore, it's worth me bumping that person up to the top of my priority list and reaching out to someone at their company, basically to initiate a conversation because it's more likely that they're actually looking for something like what I offer. And the last sales signal here is technologies. Search for people using a specific technology. So let's say if I'm selling for PandaDoc and I want to try and sell to people who are using DocuSign, I could put DocuSign in here and bang, now I've got a list of 1,866 companies and 4,960 people at those companies who are in my buying group who are likely using DocuSign. I can reach out to these people and talk about the related pain points as to why people often switch from that tool. So that advanced search is pretty darn impressive. Like I mentioned, one of my favorite tools to use is LinkedIn Sales Navigator, and I would argue that this goes deeper than that with the intent signals and more specific triggers and scoops that you can layer into the search. The next thing I want to look at is intent. So there's an entire tab just for intent, and that's where you can go a little bit deeper on some of the intent topics that I showed earlier. So I can select my intent topics, and I can also select the audience strength. So is it just one person at this company who's been searching that topic, or is it multiple? So then when I click on this company, if it's coming to my results, 8x8, it will actually give me more intent data about that. On June 1st, over 5 people from this company, 8x8, have been searching for keynote speakers and sales training. And those people were in the San Francisco office and the Romania office. So what does that give me information to do? Well, because I've fed ZoomInfo my buyer persona, I can look down here and find the right people who I can now reach out to as a result of that intent signal. It's telling me, hey, these are the top people at this account you should probably reach out to based on this intent signal. This is dope. I feel like I've been an idiot for not using this for the past few months. Tracker, this is interesting. Stay in the loop when your contacts change jobs. Tell us which contacts to track and we'll do the rest. Upload a list. You upload your list of top contacts from your customer list, And if they change jobs, you can hit them up at their new company. Websites. Now this is the part where I was like, a couple of weeks ago, because it took a little while to set up and make sure there was something for us to look at in here. But basically, I inserted a little piece of code on each of my landing pages on my website, willaitken.com, where I have a sales training course and t-shirts like this one. So I inserted this piece of Zoom info code onto my website a couple of weeks ago, and now it's picking up people who are visiting my website and what companies they work for. I can now see 88 different companies who an employee at that company has visited my website. I can see that this person went on my sales coaching page, my sales courses page, and my sales team training page. I don't want that person to go to waste just because my website didn't convert them well. And because ZoomInfo knows who I sell to, it's pointed out that Chris is probably someone who I should reach out to at that account. This is reducing a lot of work for me to build lists. Let's look at the last couple places. Enhance, you can upload a list of contacts and your data might be inaccurate and it will basically cleanse that list for you and make it more accurate using their data. I will say that ZoomInfo is renowned, well known to have some of the most accurate data in the space. I'll tell a story about this actually. I used to work for a tech startup and we were using a competitive solution to ZoomInfo called LeadIQ, and every rep had their own LeadIQ license. So we were finding prospects to identify and target, using LeadIQ to pull their contact information off of LinkedIn, and then we were sequencing them in outreach. However, our sales ops and leadership team noticed that the contact information was really bad. Like half of the numbers were wrong, a lot of the emails were incorrect, so they were bouncing. So what they did was they went ahead and bought two licenses of ZoomInfo for the sales ops people, who then went through and cleansed all the data that we'd been getting from LeadIQ and then continued to add new data based on some of the signal scoops and whatnot. So in terms of accuracy, ZoomInfo, I would say, is probably renowned to be one of the better vendors in this space. Now, the last thing I'm looking at here, workflows. Everything we just ran through, you can automate to be done automatically. So for example, if I go to site visit targeting and I try it, I can set up a trigger. For example, when someone visits willaitken.com on any page from any company, ZoomInfo is automatically going to discover up to 3 contacts per company that visits my website within the sales team buying committee that I've set up, and it's going to create them a contact and import them into HubSpot, which is what I use as my sequencing platform. So then I can begin targeting them automatically, and I don't even have to build a list anymore. It's just doing that all for me. That's like half of a salesperson's job is trying to find good prospects worth reaching out to. Building lists isn't talking to people. And if we're not talking to people, we're generally not driving the results we want to in sales. I can now have a list ready to go, or if I'm running a whole team, I can have people's and reps lists assigned to them based on geography, territories, intent data. I've got one here that if they add competitive technology, so if they end up going and buying Salesforce or LinkedIn Sales Navigator, then I could reach out to them and say, hey, so you recently invested in LinkedIn Sales Navigator. I actually have some great training on that. Here's a video. Would you be curious to know what else is possible with the platform? I've been working with teams X, Y, and Z to achieve this. Okay, so that was a lot. Let's talk about some pros and cons of ZoomInfo. Let's start with the pros over here. That search functionality is probably one of the most in-depth ones I've seen on any platform, including LinkedIn Sales Navigator. Better you can build your list with smart searches like those, the less research you might actually have to do on each individual prospect in that list to reach out to them. Another pro, the intent and the web visits, insane. If I can see what companies are spending time on my website, they identify people who may be slightly interested or researching before they reach out to me or one of my competitors, and therefore I can get to that company early before they get too deep into their evaluation or pass me up for another company. I could keep going on forever, but the last big was the workflows. So you can basically automate all of your list building using AI, using intent signals, and designate people into sequences without you ever having to build a list again. Game changing for me as a business owner because I'm time strapped, and it's game changing for sales teams because you no longer have to get your sales team spending their time building lists. Instead, all they have to do is execute on the delivery of that list on the phone, emailing people, or on calls with prospects. Onto the cons. This is the big one, and I know I was gonna have to talk about this. ZoomInfo is expensive. It is hella pricey. I believe it's running at like over $1,000 a month per user per license of ZoomInfo. That's a lot of fucking money. You know how I mentioned before that my team bought 2 licenses just for sales ops on our team? That's because as a startup, they couldn't afford to buy every single rep on the team a license. They could only afford to enable a couple of people on the sales ops to help improve the data we were getting from the other tool that we were using. And here's the thing, when you look at ZoomInfo alongside some of its competitors, if you look at it apples to apples and say, well, that all of these are gonna help me get contact information, but they basically do the same thing. Let me look at LeadIQ. Yeah, so LeadIQ is like $79 a month. Comes a lot harder to justify spending 10 times more for a tool that offers the same promise. I think with any pricing conversation, it's a question of value. So yeah, that price point is going to put some people off. And I guess if I had to try and justify that price point to myself, it would be a case of, okay, reaching out to people with wrong emails and wrong contact details, I am wasting time. And if I'm time strapped or my time is worth a lot of money to me, then that compounds over time. And it only compounds more the larger the team size is. If you have a team of, let's say, 50 reps, and each of them are making 100 calls a day, it's 5,000 calls a day, 25,000 a week. And there's a 10% difference in the data quality of ZoomInfo versus one of the alternatives that's cheaper. That 10% difference means that you're doing 2,500 calls to numbers that are out of date and don't work. And at that point, when you start to calculate the backwards cost, opportunity cost, and potential damage that's doing to the team, that's how I suppose you would justify that price point. But ultimately, with anything, value is in the eye of whoever's buying. And ZoomInfo has a lot of customers, so clearly the value is there for some people. But ultimately, some people just don't have the money to be able to afford a tool like this. So in those cases, they're probably going to go for a cheaper alternative, like the tool that I've reviewed on this channel beforehand, right here. Give that video a watch, hit subscribe, and let me know, what's your experience with data intelligence solutions? What's been best for you? Love to hear your thoughts in the comment sections below. Drop a like, subscribe, press my fucking buttons, baby. Peace.